What's up, guys? I'm Machine Gun Kelly, and here are some questions from Twitter.
Hi, I'm Flair at Hotels Diablo.
Hotels Diablo? You got that Twitter name?
Well, yeah. I had to show respect to one of the greatest albums of all time. If you could listen to only one song for the rest of your life, what would it be and why?
Obviously, it would be Barbie Girl by whoever the fuck that was.
What?
There's one thing that's gonna take me out of being depressed that I'm on a fucking island for the rest of my life by myself. That song will... You know what? That song will make me kill myself quicker, so I'll be out of the reality of being stuck on an island by myself.
I can feel that. Thank you so much for answering my question.
Yeah. What's up, Maya?
Hey, Chris.
Whenever you see a double X in the name, that's how I always know your gang.
Double X.
What was your question?
My question is, how does it feel to listen to your old songs when you're speaking your game into existence, now that you've made it?
Maya, were you in the car with me yesterday? That's exactly what I was just doing.
I was in the back seat. You didn't see me?
Mixtapes for the first time in like 10 years. And, a lot of my songs were about manifestation and about attaining the dream, you know, that seemed impossible. And then it's kind of crazy to see like all the things that we were prophesizing when it all seemed like out of reach, you know, it did seem impossible. So there was something really cool like and dreamy about all those lyrics and those songs. Like they were really like hopeful / hopeless.
Right, I love that. Oh my god.
It's cool. It's very cool. I can also tell what songs I recorded on our Radio Shack microphone and which ones I did not.
Hey, Kels. I'm Cece, and my question for you is, when it's finally safe to do so, where are you most excited to tour and perform that you haven't been to yet?
Well, it's safe enough for everyone to go to football games all the time, so I'm pretty sure everyone's safe. It's safe enough to do shows. It's kind of insane that that political rallies would be allowed to happen, but things like concerts, which are actual spiritual escapes for people,
yes,
should not be allowed to happen, because some people have church, others have concerts, right? Like political rallies does not.
Right.
Unless they're protesting, you know what I'm saying? Unless it's of the people, but I'm talking about like,
yeah,
you know what I mean? Elect me as president. That doesn't save me from anything. It actually like reminds me how shitty everything is. You know what I mean? Like I think.
Yeah, I feel you.
I'm ready to go. My guitar's packed, literally. Tell me I can play and play. Jamie loves Kate. That's cute. Mm-hmm. Whoever Kate is, you're lucky.
Are you aware that your newest album is literally every emo kid's dream album?
That's cool. Nah, man, that's awesome. That makes me very happy. Thanks. Colson loves Jamie.
What's your favorite track off the new album, and which are you most excited to play live?
My favorite track is Lonely because it's in 6/8, like the measure of it. So that's cool because usually everything's in 4. Obviously, emotionally, it's like the closest to my heart. So, I mean, I love that song. Most excited to play though, I mean, probably Bloody Valentine. It's a little ridiculous that like the biggest song off the album is unplayable. We haven't played it live one time yet, you know what I mean? Like I've never had a year. I mean, Earth hasn't had a year like this, so never mind. I don't know what I'm talking about. No one's playing shit. But I think that whole album is also like 26 minutes or something like that. I could play the whole album and then have like the entire show ready to go afterwards, so I would play the whole thing front to back. Hi, Maya. Are you back?
Hey, Colson.
This is the same Maya. Cool.
Yeah, it's me. I'm back. What should I make my senior quote?
Life sells lies you should never buy.
Oh my God, it's literally perfect. Thank you so much. Thank you. I love it so much. I love you.
Yeah, double X, let's go.
Hey, Kels, what was the most memorable moment while recording TTMD?
I do enjoy that a lot of the moments I don't remember because it felt like it was kind of like mind and body was being channeled by...
Yeah, spontaneity.
That music energy, so it was kind of like there was nothing being written, there was no like thoughts. Like the second we would start riffing, I would start saying stuff, and you know, World War III was my friend Nick playing guitar at the same time as Travis, all jamming at the same time, and me with a 57 mic, just like
so cool,
talking my shit, and so like that was all of us jamming
the song together. Favorite song.
It turned out to be a really cool song that made the album. My favorite memory that I actually like remember was me promising Travis that it was gonna be an early night so he'd be able to, you know, get home around like midnight or whatever. I had already called like a last minute studio session anyway, so it was kind of like a favor session.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, dude, it's gonna be an early night, whatever. And Trippy hit me around like 11:30. I was like, ooh, like Trippy hit me up though. Should we, you know, like, should we just wait? He's gonna come to the studio. We did want him on that one song. He was like, yeah, we'll wait for Trippy to come. It's around like 1:30. I'm like, brrr. He's like eating a full face of like lasagna or some shit. I'm like, oh shit, I thought you were coming to the studio. He's like, yeah, I just had to eat real quick. He's like, I'm about to come now. Fast forward, it's like 3 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock maybe. Trippy pulls up. We're like, all right, bet. So like, here's the song that we're thinking you should be on. That song was Split a Pill and Break Up. He was like, nah, not that song. And so Travis was like, I've already been here way too fucking long, and so then we had to just come up with a whole new song. And we did All I Know.
Such a good song. One of my favorites. Right. So good.
This is Machine Gun Kelly here with Spin, and I really actually appreciate you watching because I'm just sitting here smoking, talking shit. Thank you. You'll be mine.